from this DS or from this DQ, you will see that I will have something like this. You can see that the magnitude of this vector and this vector are equal, right? The magnitude of this vector and this vector are equal. And from symmetry, if I look at the component, on the direction of the axis of the ring, and the component on the direction that perpendicular to the axis of the ring,
I left my iPad. Did you see your Apple iPad?
iPad?
Yeah. Sorry to interrupt.
I don't think so.
Maybe office now.
Yeah. Yes, maybe.
Can I
yes, yes.
Sorry to interrupt.
Okay. Do you have
office?
Oh, it's in the office.
In the office. Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Kapumaka.
Okay, let's go back to our problem. If you calculate, the figure is not that good, but try to imagine that I want to calculate the component of DE on the direction of the axis of the ring. This is the direction of the axis of the ring, and this is the direction perpendicular to the ring. You can see that the component of the DE in the direction perpendicular to the axis of the ring will cancel, right? This component, these two components will cancel because of the symmetry of the problem. But this component are not. So what does it mean? It means that we just want to know the component of the DE in the direction of the axis of the ring, right? We want to know only this component of DE, right? It's not necessary to calculate the component that perpendicular to the axis of the ring, because if you look at the DE from this piece and you look at the DE from this piece that on the opposite side of the ring, this component will cancel. This component will cancel, and this is true also if you look at the DE from this piece and from this piece that on the opposite side of the ring. So what we have to calculate is just the component of the electric field in the direction of the axis of the ring, okay? And what is that component? You can see that if this is an angle theta, okay, you can see that I may call it as the DEC, which means the component on the set on the C axis only, and it is equal to the DE cos theta. Okay? It is a DE cos theta. And It means that now we have the expression of the electric field. Okay? What we have to do next is to sum up the electric field from every pieces on the ring. So, we will have that. We will have that. Is equal to the integration of dEc. Okay, and what is the limit of integration here? What is the limit of integration here? The limit of integration here is around the ring. Okay? Limit of integration here is around the ring. So, if we put everything to the DE set, we have that integration of dE is equal to the integration of the dE cos theta. Okay? dE cos theta. And this is integral equal to the integral of k dq, which dq I will write dq as a lambda ds, okay, over r square cos theta. Okay. And now we can do the calculation. But the calculation is extremely simple. Why? First, because this k is a constant, right? We can take the constant out of the integration. Next, this lambda is a constant. You can take this lambda out of the integration. Next, r is a constant. R is a constant, so you can take r out of the integration. Next, theta is a constant. Why theta is a constant? If you look at the figure again, you can see that if you look at any point on the ring and you want to see the theta, from the symmetry of the problem, if you draw the line from this point, for example, if I draw the line from this point to the point P, like this, the angle here is also theta, right? If I draw a line like this, the angle here is also theta. So it means that on every point on the ring, if you draw a line from each piece to the point P, and the angle here is always theta. So it means that theta is a constant. And when theta is a constant, it means that cos theta is a constant also. So you can take the cos theta out of the integration. So what left? We have that k lambda over r square cos theta integration of ds. Okay? And what is the integration of DS? What is the integration of DS? You can see that I mentioned this, that the integration here is around the ring. And what is DS? What is DS? DS is the ring, the length of the piece of this piece, right? So when you do the integration around the ring, it means that you sum up this DS around the ring, right? You sum up this DX around the ring. And when you sum up this DS around the ring, it means that it is just the